Hello and greetings from Iceland. Yesterday turned out to be very special because we all expected the next eruption to be about to start, and it almost did. But it was less than 1 million cubic meters of magma that took off this time. Not enough to make it through the crust, but enough to evacuate the Blue Lagoon and the town Grindavík, so things got very tense for a while. And what a day for a volcano chaser like me. It started actually perfectly, with a beautiful sunrise, fried eggs and a few slices of crispy bacon. Before I loaded up the car with all my stuff, all cameras working, all batteries full, all memory cards empty, and after I had filled it up with petrol, I drove straight to the Reykjanes Peninsula, thinking that I might see some fire today. But the only fire that I got was a misfire from my engine, since I had just filled my diesel-powered Jeep with 98-octane gasoline, and the car really didn't like it. So here I am, waiting for my friend to come and tow the car back to Reykjavík. And after that we did a tour to buy fresh diesel fuel and fuel filters, and we just got back from that trip when I got the call. It's going to erupt any time now, and not the best time for my car. So he drove me to the Reykjanes Peninsula, left me there for an hour, where I did a drone tour, see how the zoom would work for the location where we expected the eruption to come up. And I can actually go a bit closer than this, but I didn't need it, since this turned out to be a failed magma intrusion. The Blue Lagoon was allowed to open up today, but I don't think they will do so until tomorrow, Monday morning. But the residents and companies in Grindavík can return at their own risk, although the next evacuation could just as well occur tonight, according to experts. And they say that it isn't going to take this magma chamber under there, or magma sill, long time, to pressurize enough to send us all the somewhere between 9 and 10 million cubic meters of magma up. So we are still in this waiting pattern. And the longer we wait, the bigger the eruption could get. And this is really everything I can say about this right now. We are still waiting. So I came back to Reykjavík last night with a whole lot of experience when it comes to volcano chasing and fuel pumping. But I might have one excuse, because I recently bought a Toyota Land Cruiser 120. It was like a month ago, and the plan was to see how it would fit me, because I need to be a lot on the highlands next summer, film some of the highland volcanoes, and there are very few bridges on the highlands. So those old cruisers, they are very popular workhorses here in Iceland, lots of them around, and it is the first diesel-powered car that I have. And old habits are hard to break. So I spent a Sunday morning in my friend's garage, and it was a dirty, smelling and boring job, but after a few attempts, it's alive again. And it looks as I have to stay in Reykjavík a little longer than I expected. And while I'm waiting for the next alarm to go off, I will be filming and processing videos. It is very time consuming, and I have also this collaboration project that I'm trying to find time to dive into, and I will talk about that very soon. I've just been extremely busy since I got excellent filming conditions for my videos about the volcanoes around the city, or conditions that I didn't expect to get this time of year. And this is Iceland today. And the Reykjanes Peninsula is here, still very snowy. And while the snow is making the landscape features pop big time, I'm not staying in, not during bright and good days. And the last headline about the volcano that I'm seeing in the news today is saying that we might be getting some big news very soon. So I might just try to repeat the tour from yesterday tonight, go out on the peninsula and wait a bit. But for sure, with a full tank of fresh diesel this time. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.